Mate, the world's gone boxing mad lately. All those crap farts, KSR and Logan Paul, lad. That YouTube versus TikTok boxing thing coming up soon. And now, Jake Paul has taken on Funky Ben Askren. Now, you might not know this, but I'm a bit of a boxing expert, I am, right? So I thought I'd make a quick video telling you everything you need to know about the sport of boxing. Let's go! Mate, it's crap. Listen, hear me out, right? I do not get boxing. Because boxing's supposed to be a fight, right? And it is. Boxing is definitely that. It is a fight in its purest form, right? Except you can't headbutt your opponent. Obviously. But nor can you kick him. For some reason. Or elbow him. Or use your knees. Or do any takedowns or slams. And no submissions, right? Definitely no jiu-jitsu. Some of those positions look kind of gay. So no. But apart from those, you can do whatever you want. So long as you wear these big padded marshmallow gloves on your hands. Like, Jesus Christ, man! What is this? Who the fuck came up with these pussy as fuck rules? The concerned mothers of the guys fighting? Why is this soft shit? Honestly, they're one stipulation away from just saying, actually, do you know what? Fuck it, right? No punches either. Let's just have sex instead. If you're gonna fight, right? Just fucking fight! Like, don't get me wrong. I can see why they banned certain things, right? Because if they didn't, 90% of fights would end in the first 10 seconds after one clean kick to the balls. But what the fuck, man? This is taking it a bit too far, don't you think? Seriously, the whole point of a fight is to try and kick the other guy's ass, right? Except you can't do that in boxing, because if you kick anything, you get disqualified. Stupid. Listen, I'll talk about Jake Paul in a bit, right? But come on, Ben! Listen, don't even worry about boxing him, mate. I know it's against the rules, right? But just kick him in the dick. Take the DQ loss and raise your hands up high. Mate, you'll be loved forever. Now listen, not gonna lie, right? As much as I'd love to tune in to watch to see if that actually happens. What? $50? Mate, I'm not paying $50 for this crap fight, right? However, I was able to get the fight for just $15. What? Thanks to NordVPN. Listen, I did a NordVPN spot at the end of my Pokemon video 3 weeks ago, right? And just look at the amazing response it got from you lot. Especially this one. The customer's always right, eh, Nord? Seriously, right? NordVPN is a bargain-finding machine that everyone needs to have. It's so useful, right? Because it lets you find the best international prices for services you want to buy. Like, this is no bullshit, right? I used to pay £10 a month for Netflix alone, right? But with NordVPN, you can get all this for £8.70. I'm paying less and getting so much more. Now, which one of these two would you rather have? Do you know what I mean? Thanks, Nord! All you have to do is go to nordvpn.com/grade to download the Nord software, right? And you can choose wherever in the world you want to be. Just click on the country whose servers you want to connect to, and then go to the website of the services you want to buy, right? And a lot of the time, you will see huge price changes. Mate, companies do this all the time. Like, I now get Netflix for £4.30 a month, because that's how much it costs in Brazil. Amazon Prime Video costs just £10 for the entire year, because that's how much it costs in India. And I haven't watched a single fucking annoying YouTube advert in 3 weeks, thanks to YouTube Premium, right? Which I'll get for just over $1 a month, because that's how much it costs in Argentina. And you can get all these prices too with NordVPN. And these are just some of the benefits of having NordVPN. They've got a risk-free 30-day money-back guarantee, right? In case you somehow don't like it. So you literally have no reason not to get it. So what are you waiting for, mate? Go to nordvpn.com/grade and get yourself some NordVPN today. They've got a huge discount going on right now, right? And if you use code grade A, not only does it help out my channel, but you get a bonus month for free. As if the deal wasn't good enough already. Go to nordvpn.com/grade now and get some NordVPN in your life today. But let's talk Jake Paul. Now listen, Jake Paul insists that he's a real fighter, right?
But I'm a real fighter.
And he is. Jake Paul is definitely that. Because Jake is doing the top three things that every professional boxer does to be successful. He's training hard, he's promoting his fights, and most importantly, cherry-picking easy opponents. Listen, one of the biggest issues with boxing, right, being the crap sport that it is that in the boxing world, there's a huge emphasis placed on being undefeated.
I do want to make this point, though. Boxing is a misconception that you have to be undefeated to be worthy of a title. They're wrong.
In boxing, they take a fighter, and the goal is to keep that fighter undefeated as long as possible.
Boxing has got to be, you got to be undefeated. One blemish on your record, and it does something.
And given that's the case, right, to protect their precious undefeated status, what boxers often end up doing is specifically avoiding fights with anyone who's any good, you know, because they might actually beat them, and instead only fight people who are shit.
This guy's striking is that of a grandma, quite literally.
Well, no wonder you chose to fight him then, eh, Jake? So on the surface, you see a boxer boasting that he's undefeated, right?
I'm 3-0, 3 KOs, 2-0 as a professional with 2 KOs.
But that's not really saying much when your professional boxing career consists of some random FIFA YouTuber kid with the biggest fucking nose I've ever seen, the joint 13th shortest person to ever play in the NBA, and a retired MMA fighter who not only just had surgery, but was specifically known for having shit boxing skills during his MMA career.
This guy's striking is that of a grandma. Quite literally.
Well, good to see you challenging yourself then, eh, Jake? Very impressive.
I've never seen anybody in the history of America get so rich and so famous out of having complete wimps throwing punch at their faces.
And my God, is Jake getting rich and famous off of doing so. So I'd like to take a page out of Jake Paul's book, right? And officially announce my professional boxing debut. And I'm gonna really test myself the same way Jake Paul has done so far, right? By calling out that little cunt, Ryan's Toy Reviews.
This guy's striking is that of a 9-year-old. Quite literally.
I am undefeated, right? And I will remain undefeated. Real boxer, right here. You're dead, cunt. But I'm gonna fuck you up. Come get some, Ryan, you little 9-year-old prick. But listen, I'm not hating on Jake, right? I respect the hustle. I normally love a cocky, arrogant cunt who doesn't give a fuck, right? So long as they have some personality. And I'm sorry, right? But Jake really doesn't. I just think it's stupid that Jake keeps saying that he's a real boxer, right? But still hasn't fought anyone who's actually a boxer. And he then calls himself a fighter and calls out MMA fighters, but then says, I don't actually want to fight. Can we just box instead? Where the rules say you can't use the fighting styles that you spent your entire lives becoming experts at and could easily murder me with. Only boxing, thanks. That's some weak shit. Mate, just fuck KSI. Anyways, Ryan, you've got till the end of the week to respond, you little 9-year-old bitch, or it's a W for me. Come follow me on Twitch if you want. Tell me how surprised you are that I haven't vanished again yet. And don't forget to get yourself some NordVPN too. Alright, cheers boys. Peace.